fly away to glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, saints and fellow sinners, we are gathered here tonight to bid farewell to the menace of John Barleycorn. I am God's revenue officer, and I'm here to tell you about the evils of Demon Rum and the pain. Oh, the pain, the awful pain on society from the liquor traffic. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Hey, can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Can I hear an amen? Hallelujah.
Amen, hallelujah.
All right, you have the spirit. Let's get out your money. Let's take up a collection. Oh, just kidding. I was only checking to see if you're still paying attention. That's right. To properly introduce myself, I am the Reverend Billy Sunday. And this is not my first visit to Elizabeth City. In 1920, I was invited to Betsytown, and I gave a sermon in this very sanctuary. And then I spoke to all the young people at the high school nearby. And after that, I had lunch at the Southern Hotel. Oh, yes, the whole town was very warm and cordial to me, with the exception of one, W.O. Saunders, the editor of a local small newspaper called The Independent. But I'll talk more about him later. As a bit of background, I am the most influential evangelist of the early 20th century. Now, we're talking about the time before the invention of loudspeakers and television and the radio. It was just me and my big mouth and the Holy Spirit everywhere I went. I evangelized to over 100 million Americans in my career, and among them, 1 million walked the sawdust path to salvation at my tent revivals. You might say I was the world's first televangelist without the benefit of television. Well, I wasn't always a minister. Before that, before I heard the call of God, I was a Major League Baseball player. That's right. I played from 1883 to 1890 for the Chicago White Stockings. And I was blessed with agility. So I was the first player known to be able to run around all the bases in 14 seconds. And I set another record of 96 stolen bases in one single season. A record that stood unbroken until Ty Cobb came along. Now, I had a great future in baseball. I had a great future there. But I gave it all up to follow the Lord. You see, I went to a revival in Chicago in the late 1880s, and it changed my life. I dedicated my life to God, and I gave up a sizable, huge salary as a professional baseball player just to make a pittance as a minister in Chicago. But before long, I was attracting big crowds, and eventually I became very influential and very wealthy. My preaching style was very energetic. I was up and I was down and I was all around everywhere, filled with the Holy Spirit. I used a lot of baseball references in my sermons. I would say things like, "Slide into heaven," and "The devil thinks I'm out, but the Lord says I'm safe." I would also say colorful things like, "Going to church doesn't make you a Christian any more than going to a garage makes you an automobile." Now, as an evangelist, I played a significant role in the passage of the 18th Amendment to the Constitution of the United States The prohibition of the making, transportation, and sales of alcohol in all the United States. I was the eternal, dedicated, unyielding enemy of the liquor traffic. Now, I think that alcohol has its place, but its place is hell! I challenge you to show me where alcohol and the saloon have done any good at all for things like education, business, church, morals, or anything else that we hold dear. No, the saloon promises good cheer and brings sorrow. The saloon promises prosperity and brings adversity. The saloon promises happiness, but brings misery. I was determined to defeat it. Is that it? Oh, okay. I was determined to defeat it! Pastors all across this country were preaching against the evils of alcohol. And one could not stop the tide of interest in the Prohibition Amendment. You could sooner dam up the Niagara Falls with toothpicks than you could stop the reform wave sweeping this land. I used my own fame and wealth to accomplish the goal of the passage of the 18th Amendment. In 1920, when I visited here, I was rejoicing at the passage of the Prohibition Amendment. And yet, in every town I've found, there's some tongue wag there just out to make some trouble. And in this town, it was that little editor, W.O. Saunders. He called me Hellfire Bill. And he described me as a screaming, howling, dancing, dirty-mouthed, bullet-headed, arrogant, bloated, dollar-chasing parody of the religion of Jesus Christ. Sounds like I made quite an impression on W.O. Saunders. Ironically, his wife was on the committee that greeted me when I arrived here in town, and she and everyone else treated me with warm welcome. Well, I must move on now. I'm off next to Norfolk, a town full of sailors. And before I go, I must give you a bit of advice. Attend a religious revival if you get the chance. There are those who say they're useless, that they don't work, that their effects are temporary. But I say, so are the effects of bathing. But you do it anyway. Good night.